All of us, wherever we come from, whether we are Europeans, North Americans, or Africans, or Asians, Latin Americans, we can learn, we must learn from each other. I think the cause of so much angst and pain in the world is based on the notion that some cultures are superior to others, that some societies, some races, have a predestination to rule over others, to guide others, to teach others. And I think for too long, for the last perhaps 500, 600 years, Europeans have projected this narrative of themselves as the civilizers of the rest of humanity. I think for the first time in these 500 years, the asymmetries of power that have always been there in the age of Europe are breaking down, are changing. We are seeing emergent powers elsewhere, in Asia, in Latin America, in Africa, and we are seeing a rebalancing of global hegemonies. And I hope, in fact, I know this to be a fact, that younger Europeans are more interested in what they can learn in a dialogic fashion with their counterparts in other parts of the world. And so I hope, and I can see change, even in this continent. I can see the arrogance of the past dissipating, and I hope that that continues. I think one challenge, for example, that I have just noticed, because I was in Rome for 6 months until the end of September this year, I noticed a kind of apathy towards the hordes of masses that are fleeing Asia, Middle East, and Africa, looking for safety elsewhere. I think the response by governments in Europe was horrible, has been horrible. But I think I noticed a particular ray of hope. Young people in general in Europe are more empathetic and more willing to dialogue and to listen to others and to help others who may be in distress. And so again, like I said earlier, I hope that continues. I think the sins of history are there. They cannot be undone. But I think people can commit not to repeat those sins,